Good afternoon to you all. You're all very welcome this afternoon. Good to see so many of you back here again with us today. This is the seventh day of our novena, and as our theme of the novena is faith and family today, we concentrate on the Mass, bringing Mary home. And our speaker this afternoon is John F. Dean, Mayo poet. I'll be speaking a little bit more about John later on, just before he speaks to us. So I welcome you all wherever you've come from, near and far. Pilgrims, parishioners, and visitors alike, you're most welcome. We join our prayers again, as we always do, during the course of this novena to Our Lady of Knock. Whatever intention you may have, need, or indeed thanksgiving, we place it before her. Those of you who are invalid or sick amongst us as well, you always have a special part and of the novena here with us, and a special place in the novena with us. I welcome those who are joining us on the internet and on our webcam from all over the world. We again join your prayers with ours here, and we hope that you join in our prayers. And if you have the prayers to Our Lady of Knock, that you join in at that particular time for your own intentions and your own needs. Our choir this afternoon is the Kelchmach Choir, with their director, George Lee, and organist is our own director of music here at the Shrine, Una Nolan. You're very welcome back to us. Good to have you with us, and thank you for being here. And so, as we always do, we pause for a moment or two of quietness and stillness before we begin our Mass, knowing that the Lord is here present amongst us, that he listens to our prayers, and we ask Our Lady of Knock to intercede before him on our behalf. We're here as God's family. We're here with all our ups and downs, all our bits and pieces of life drawn into the celebration of this Eucharist itself. So we pause now for a moment of quietness and maybe stillness before we begin our celebration, just to maybe gather our thoughts, gather together maybe where we are, the sacred space that we all inhabit, that we all share here this afternoon. So a moment of quietness and stillness for preparation. So friends, a very warm welcome to you all once again, and joining me here in the sanctuary along with Father Patrick Burke, Master of Ceremonies this afternoon, is Father Pat O'Brien, Parish Priest of Carrigastrann, priest of our own Archdiocese of Tuam. Father Pat, you're very welcome, and thank you very much for celebrating this Mass with us this afternoon. I also welcome all our concelebrating priests. So I invite Father Pat now to lead us in the celebration of the Eucharist.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And before we offer up the Eucharist, we call to mind for a moment our humanity. Blessed in Mary, revealing the fullness of what we are as human beings, the fullness of our call to love others and to serve God, and to come into the presence of all that light, all that beauty, and all that mercy. And we ask that we place that humanity before our Son and his mercy and his great forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who give hope to your people in time of distress, grant that we, who keep the memorial of the Blessed Virgin, Our Lady of Knock, may, through her intercession, be steadfast in the faith during our earthly pilgrimage to heaven, and so come to eternal glory with all the angels and saints. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Zephaniah. Shout for joy, daughter of Zion. Israel, shout aloud. Rejoice, exult with all your heart, daughter of Jerusalem. The Lord has repealed your sentence. He has driven your enemies away. The Lord, the King of Israel, is in your midst. You have no more evil to fear. When that day comes, word will come to Jerusalem. Zion, have no fear. Do not let your hands fall limp. The Lord your God is in your midst, a victorious warrior. He will exult with joy over you. He will renew you by his love. He will dance with shouts of joy for you as on a day of festival. The word of the Lord.
The Lord. Nothing more shall I want. He leads me along the path of right, according to his word. The Lord, he will be my shepherd. Nothing more shall I want. He leads me along the path of right, according to his word. The Lord, he will be my shepherd. Nothing more shall I want. In valleys of green he lets me lie. To restful waters he leads me. If ever I walk in darkness, nothing more would I fear. Every day of my life, my home will be in God's house. As long as I shall live, the Lord, he will be my shepherd. Nothing more shall I want. He leads me along the path of right, according to his word.
Please stand for the gospel. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Mary set out and went as quickly as she could to a town in the hill country of Judah. She went into Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. Now, as soon as Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She gave a loud cry and said, "Of all women, you are the most blessed, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Why should I be honored with a visit from the mother of my Lord? For the moment your greeting reached my ears, the child in my womb leapt for joy. Yes, blessed is she who believed that the promise made her by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit exults in God my Savior, because he has looked upon his lowly handmaid. Yes, from this day forward, all generations will call me blessed, for the Almighty has done great things to me. Holy is his name. And his mercy reaches from age to age for those who fear him. He has shown the power of his arm. He has routed the proud of heart. He has pulled down princes from their thrones and exalted the lowly. The hungry he has filled with good things, the rich sent empty away. He has come to the help of Israel, his servant, mindful of his mercy, according to the promises he made to our ancestors, of his mercy to Abraham and to his descendants forever." Mary stayed with Elizabeth about 3 months and then went back home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You are the Word of God.
The power of the Magnificat has impressed us for so long in terms of understanding of who Mary is and how we can identify with Mary. And Mary, I remember one writer talking about Mary and how to describe Mary. He spoke about the whiteness of Mary, and that Mary wasn't just ordinary white, as you might see her there in the statue. It's not just a statuary white. And he said it wasn't even Purcell white. It's Marian white. There's a type of whiteness, a type of image about Mary, but even that doesn't do Mary justice. Mary was someone who was real. Mary is the mother of God. Mary is somebody that is very, very real to us here in Knock, certainly real to the people who witnessed her in 1879. And I suppose the Magnificat draws that essence in terms of Mary's expression of faith in God and what he has done for her. And this afternoon we have as our speaker John F. Dean, Mayo poet, who will be speaking Mass, Bringing Mary Home. He's already conducted a workshop for us with the title Realizing Mary, Faith and Family. It was a wonderful workshop. Wonderful. And those of you who might get a chance to go at 6 o'clock, I highly recommend it. John himself was born in Achill, author of several publications of poetry and 2 novels, as well as short stories. He's the founder of Poetry Ireland and a member of that special group called Eas Dhána, which is a group of artists around the country, a select group that are brought together for their imagination and talent, and certainly highlighting the talent we have in this country in terms of poetry and story and various art forms. In 2007, he was honored by the French government as a Chevalier, or a Knight of the Order of Arts and Letters. It is my privilege and honor, and we extend a very warm Knock welcome to John F. Dean.
Good afternoon. It's perhaps not very often that you get a knight from Achill Island speaking to you about the Virgin Mary. I came here to Knock as a child about twice every year when I was growing up, and remember well walking around the old church, saying the rosary and suffering rain. That is my memory of rain. And I was a child and didn't understand what on earth was going on, but I knew I was supposed to pray. So I always remember praying that Mayo would win the Connacht title a particular year. Didn't happen every time, but she did answer the prayer now and again. And she has done very well so far this year. And we can all pray that Dublin will also be defeated fairly soon. I was born and brought up on Achill Island, and during my adolescent years, Crowpatrick was always there, sometimes visible, sometimes a ghost beyond Atlantic mists. And from Kiel, I could see by night the magical beam from the Clare Island lighthouse as it swept slowly across the bay. The mountain and that light, they became something of a dream for me, something magical, something distant, something beyond me, known only in my imagination, because I never, in all those years, climbed Crowpatrick, nor did I ever make it out as far as Clare Island. I suppose when something is so close to you, you keep putting off having to bother doing what you know you should be doing. In very much the same way, Mary, the mother of Jesus and my God, was a statue, dressed in gentle blues and whites, fair as the moon, bright as the sun, terrible as an army set in battle array. But she, too, for me in those years, was a dream. For dogs, I knew, barked at the moon. You are not supposed to look at the sun, and I am opposed to violence in all forms, and particularly to battles, armies in battle array. We also had a picture on the kitchen wall, and I'd like you to envisage it if you can. I'm sure you've all seen it. It was a picture called The Mother of Perpetual Succor. It was an icon, a very strange, very remote, very beautiful icon. And I loved it, but it meant very little to me. Just like the statue of the child Jesus of Prague, that triangular kind of statue whose head kept falling off and that you had to stick on with plaster so very often. All of that meant so very, very little to me. However, I did eventually climb Crowpatrick. By then, I was 68 years of age and rather unfit. But it was a fine morning, and I set out, my knapsack on my back, as cheery as a Boy Scout. It took me about 10 minutes to realize that I was making a very big mistake. Reality hit me. I got sore and tired before I knew where I was, but I stuck it out and made it up as far as the saddle, if you know Crowpatrick. And there I took a long rest. Perhaps I shouldn't have, because the rains came and the rest of the mountain disappeared, the top half of it disappeared. But I carried on and I made it to the top. I remember leaning against the wall of the chapel, absolutely exhausted, realizing I had reached the chapel, but still, although I was leaning against it, the rain was so heavy, I couldn't see it. And that coming down was one of the most difficult things I think I've ever done. I will never climb Crowpatrick again. It has become a reality to me, and I respect it far more than I ever did before. And then Clare Island, the lighthouse. I was lucky enough to spend one night there this summer as a kind of gift, a grace. It's now a 5-star hotel. The light is not used anymore, but we were given a room called the Achill View Room. And it was incredibly beautiful to look out over the sea from a new angle and see where I was born from a distance in a totally different light. The island was totally different, and the lighthouse was totally different from what I had ever imagined it would be. So now I know Clare Island, and I respect it and the lighthouse very much. I was also born on the 8th of December in the year 1943, when the war was on. Because of the date and the feast that was in it, the Feast of the Immaculate Conception, I was given as middle name Mary. Caused me some problems in Bunnacurry National School as I was growing up. But it did help to inculcate in me a consciousness of Mary and a certain amount of love for it, for her. I tried to make that devotion a reality. But sometimes I think of the litany that we used to say when we'd speak of the Tower of David, the mystical rose, the Tower of Ivory, the House of Gold. And I found it very hard to feel myself in any way able to speak to somebody that was a house of gold or a tower of ivory. It was very beautiful, the words are lovely, but I couldn't get past them. So I made a study of Mary, of who she was, of her first century Palestine, where she lived under the very aggressive Roman rule. I think I got to know her so much better as a very real living person. I have realized Mary. And now I can feel that I speak with her, honor her, and love her. And what I find far more important and more difficult to do is to be aware that Mary loves me, and to be able to allow that love to penetrate into myself. I find that difficult, but I try. And when I tried to pray to Mary, I found I was always using words that other people had given me. The Hail Mary, the Rosary, the Memorare, all very beautiful, very real words. But now I realize I was talking too much at her, using other people's words. Why didn't I just stop, try and say my own words to somebody that I might get to know, and then listen to see is there a response? And there is. So who is Mary, and who was she? Many, many studies have been done about her life and times. And roughly, this is the way I see her now. Mary, whose name was and is Miriam, was a young Jewish woman, scarcely past puberty when she was engaged to Joseph, a local young man. She was asked if she would consent to bring the Son of God into the world. She assented. She made a difficult journey, which we have just heard, to her cousin Elizabeth, across very dangerous territory, to be there for the birth of John the Baptist. She knew the pains and fears of giving birth. She suffered the dangers and dread of being a refugee, an asylum seeker in Egypt, because the life of her child was threatened. She knew the sufferings and anxieties of bringing up children, and that truancy of the bold boy, Jesus, who disappeared in Jerusalem and vanished for 3 days. What a nasty thing to do to one's parents. And that upset Mary, and she asked, "Why did you do this?" And I was happy to see, well, Mary didn't understand everything, so I could love her and understand her even a bit more. She watched her child die a dreadful death. She was there at the crucifixion, and she was there with the disciples in the upper room afterwards. This is the real Mary, a living, suffering, and loving woman who knew and knows still all our human difficulties, all our human anxieties. She is the one who brought Christ into the world. She is still the one who brings Christ into our homes, into our lives, into our families. She is the real person, friend, woman, worker, whom we invite into our homes. So whatever happened in Knock in August of 1879, and whatever it is that keeps on happening here, we know for facts and faith that Mary of Nazareth, Miriam of Nazareth, is close to us as patron of our lives should we offer ourselves to her care, and as exemplar, persevering and unquestioning love. I mentioned earlier on the painting, the picture of Mary, Mother of Perpetual Succor, and that it was on the wall of our house. And I've written a poem for the first, this is a new poem which I've written today, because I understand things a little bit better by forcing myself to shape my thoughts by a poem. As a child as well, I was a lonesome kind of a guy. I used to love to ramble around the island of Achill on my own. Nowadays, everywhere I ramble, I am happy to feel that there is a presence with me. And that presence is still that same Mary, the Mother of Perpetual Succor, which I couldn't understand at all in those earlier years. So this is a new poem, and I'm calling it Icon. I found no comfort in the eyes, nor in the stylized dark night blue and gold star threaded drapes and garments. This was, I was told, Mother of Perpetual Succor. The gaze of that teenage child boy was turned away towards winged angels in a brown sky. And the words troubled me, Succor and Perpetual, and the alien title, Icon, something Eastern and vaguely threatening. What I loved in those days was the sense and pleasure I knew of being alone, scuffing my shoes on the wooden floor of the hayloft, where spillicles of hay still lifted in almost invisible hay dust, making me sneeze. And I could relish the sounds of me happening in a world that I alone inhabited. Often, in the slow and persistent rains, shifting like ghosts across the fieldscapes of the west, I pressed my face against the window, suffering boredom. Mother in the dark kitchen baking soda bread, and the icon always watching me, those long and sculpted fingers, the eyes attentive, inquiring, broaching sorrow. And she watches still, and still I am aware, though now I know her name, Miriam, her village, Nazareth. I know the flowers that grow by her back door, and how she baked her barley bread in a hot oven shared by neighbors. She, along with all the living and the lost, beloved dead, is a presence now, for which I'm grateful, sensible of her care, her suffering, her ever inquiring eyes. And so, on the 8th of December, 1943, the day I was born, the world was stretched feverish under war. There was a fall of snow, they told me, over the heathlands, Achill, my island. Call me John, after the evangelist, and Francis, after the poor and love-tossed fool. And call me Mary, for the day that's in it, and for Mother, worn after the pain and tearing. There were men wading to an underworld of blood and muck during that war, uncomprehending. And I can still hear the winter storms crying through the pine grove. And Mother, Mary, Mother and Son, Madonna, a winter child. And because of that war and all its horrors, I think of Mary at the foot of the cross, watching the agonies of her son and trying to hold him for one last time before he is taken from her for burial. And I can see all mothers before Mary and ever since Mary appealing to that mother who knew the pain of the loss of a child and who is there now fully understanding, deeply sympathizing with every mother's pain. And I see Syria. I see Iraq. I see Afghanistan. I see Palestine. I see the tubs and the old wrecks of boats where desperate refugees are trying to cross the Mediterranean towards hope. And I can pray to the Queen of Heaven and to the real person, my friend, Miriam of Nazareth, that she come to our aid. Amen.
We come now to the sacrament of the sick. This is a very special part of a pilgrimage to Our Lady's shrine. When we come as pilgrims to knock, we come principally to pray. Sometimes our prayer are for the needs of others, sometimes for our own personal needs. In this sacrament, we're invited to pray for sick pilgrims. We are praying that Christ Jesus will bring into the lives of those of you who are sick the same love and compassion that he showed to the sick and burdened of his own day. We are in the presence of that same Jesus Christ today. So with faith, let us pray for our sick brothers and sisters. Lord, watch over our brothers and sisters and keep them in your love. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, relieve the sufferings of the sick and elderly here present. Christ, have mercy. Give life and health to all on whom we lay our hands in your name. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
In a moment now, we will have the imposition of hands. The laying on of hands has always been a way of imploring God to send down his mercy and his Holy Spirit on his people. As the priests now turn towards the congregation for the laying on of hands, I invite you all now to join in silent prayer for those who will be anointed. We thank God, Father, Son, and Spirit for his healing presence and for the oil of the sick, which we use in this sacrament. Our response to this prayer of thanksgiving is, Blessed be God who heals us in Christ.
Blessed be God who heals us in Christ.
Praise to you, God, the Almighty Father. You sent your Son to live among us and bring us salvation.
Blessed be God who heals us in Christ.
Praise to God, the only begotten Son. You humbled yourself to share in our humanity and you heal our infirmities.
Blessed be God who heals us in Christ.
Praise to God, the Holy Spirit, the Consoler. Your unfailing power gives us strength in our bodily weakness.
Blessed be God who heals us in Christ.
God of mercy, ease the sufferings and comfort the weakness of our brothers and sisters whom the Church anoints with this holy oil. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
A word of instruction before the anointing. It is important to understand that this is a sacrament of the Church and not a simple blessing. For this reason, only those whose health in mind or body is impaired by sickness or old age receive the sacrament. Normally, the sacrament is received only once a month. So those who are sick or elderly and wish to receive the sacrament of anointing are asked to please remember the following. Please give the priest your Christian name so that he can call you by name as he brings you in a personal way Christ's healing love. The priest will anoint you on the forehead, and your response to the anointing prayer is Amen. You'll then anoint you on your hands, and the palms of your hands, and your response again will be Amen. So we ask you not to hold anything in your hands during the anointing. So those who wish to be anointed, I invite you to come forward from your chapel, if you come forward through the wide center aisle of your chapel, to the priests, and leave. Please do not come forward through the narrow side aisles by the walls. We leave those free for you to return to your seats for your own ease of moment and safety. So you can make your way to the wide central aisle of your chapel. Those in wheelchair at the front, if you remain where you are, a priest will come to you. Indeed, anybody unable to come forward, if you or somebody could let us know, a priest will come to you also. All of us are joined together in prayer for those who are about to be anointed.
Let us pray. Loving Father, be with our brothers and sisters to protect them, watch over them, keep them in your care, and bless them with your peace. May your strength sustain all who share the sufferings of your Son. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We now stand for prayers. I think we all have beginning to get a deeper, renewed sense of everything as prayer, from the Achill Islands to the Mount of Patrick to the south hills of South Mayo bearing Our Lady, everything in creation of its very nature as it is a prayer. We at our best are at prayer, and we praise God, and we praise God for our being and for all the gifts we have and all the needs we had. So let us be at our best, as with all creation we offer the prayer of our life to God.
For Pope Francis, that through his encyclical he may help us to praise all creation and live in harmony with all living things. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That Mary may help us to proclaim the greatness of God and to be witnesses to hope, here in Knock and at home. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all mothers, that families, church, and society may celebrate and cherish the unique role of mothers. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For fine weather and the fruits of the earth, we pray to our God for all creation. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For artists, poets, and all who can help us to see beyond the immediate reality of our lives, may they be respected in their unique vocations. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our deceased loved ones, the faithful departed, and all the dead, may they rest in peace with the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Lord God, these are our prayers. We place them before you. You know the words we can say. More importantly, you know the prayers that are beyond words. You know the beating of the heart. You know the needs of the spirit of the world. Grant what we truly need to be utterly ourselves, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
We will now have the offertory collection. So I ask you to pass the collection bags along the rows as the stewards and handmaids hand them out. We thank you sincerely for whatever generosity you can give to help with the daily upkeep of the shrine here. Thank you.
pray, sisters, brothers, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, sanctify these gifts that we offer you, and grant that through the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, that our hearts may always seek out and treasure the things that are yours, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you all. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name of the Blessed Virgin Mary, for by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of her virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his friends and disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. Let us proclaim now the great mystery of our faith, our hope, and our love. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice.
Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, we may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the glorious martyrs, St. John, St. Bernard, and all the saints, and whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, we remember quietly those we love. We pray for them. We pray quietly for all the victims of poverty, war, violence, hatred, abuse in the world. And all, Lord, who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Pray together now the great prayer of Christ. I always think with the first word of the Our Father, it's the least selfish word in the world. With the first word of the Our Father, we unite it to everything, everything, and everyone that is. So conscious of that now, we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look now, Lord, not on our sins, but on the great faith, Lord, of your pilgrim people everywhere, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The great peace of Knock, the great peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you and the world. And let us, before we offer each other a sign of peace, we might just have a quiet moment and ask ourselves, is there somebody in our lives, family, neighbour, people we work with, that we actually really need to make a sign of peace with? And if there is, and I'm sure there is probably in all our lives, with the resolve that we will at least take the first step, let us offer each other now a sign of the peace of Christ.
Our Father,
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, brings all to the fullness of God's life and love. Amen.
So friends, for the distribution of Holy Communion, can I ask you to remain where you are, and the priests and ministers of the Eucharist will come amongst you. When they do so, can I ask you, when they come to the top of your line there, if you just stand as a line, please, and move back into your seat so that there is enough room for them to pass. And if there are any bags or anything there around your feet, if you'd like to pull them back a little bit, please, so that they can pass easily. Those who can only receive from the chalice can do so at the back of the altar. And if there's somebody that cannot receive or maybe doesn't wish to receive, if you'd simply indicate that to the priest or minister of the Eucharist by crossing and folding your arms in front of you. If you wish to receive a blessing, then please indicate. And so now, friends, as part of our novena, we pray together the novena prayers to Our Lady of Knock. At this time, again, we bring to mind and call to mind our particular prayer and special intention. Give praise to the Father Almighty, to His Son, Jesus Christ the Lord, to the Spirit who lives in our hearts, both now and forever. Amen. Our Lady of Knock, Queen of Ireland, you give hope to your people in a time of distress and comforted them in sorrow. You've inspired countless pilgrims to pray with confidence to your divine Son, remembering his promise, ask and you shall receive, seek and you shall find. Help me to remember that we are all pilgrims on the road to heaven. Fill me with love and concern for my brothers and sisters in Christ, especially those who live with me. Comfort me when I am sick, lonely or depressed. Teach me how to take part ever more reverently in the Holy Mass. Give me a greater love of Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament. Pray for me now and at the hour of my death. Amen. Lamb of God. Lamb of God. Lamb of God. Saint Joseph, chosen by God to be the husband of Mary, protector of the Holy Family, the guardian of the Church. Protect all families in their work and recreation, and guard us on our journey through life. Lamb of God. Lamb of God. Witnesses the world of persons. Lamb of God. Saint John, beloved disciple of the Lord, faithful priest, teacher of the Word of God, help us to hunger for the Word, to be loyal to the Mass, and to love one another. Lamb of God. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Our Lady of Knock, refuge of sinners, Queen assumed into heaven, Queen of the Rosary, Mother of Nazareth, Queen of Virgins, Help of Christians, Health of the Sick, Queen of Peace, Our Lady, Queen and Mother, Our Lady, Mother of the Church. And we mention silence of our own hearts, our own special intention. With the angels and the saints, let us pray. Give praise to the Father Almighty, to his Son, Jesus Christ the Lord, to the Spirit who lives in our hearts, both now and forever. Amen.
Having been nourished at the banquet of the heavenly Lamb, we humbly beseech you, Lord, that we who have honored in veneration the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, may live for you always in justice and holiness and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
And so now, friends, can I ask you to be seated?
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The first glorious mystery, the resurrection. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The second glorious mystery, the Ascension. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The third glorious mystery, the coming of the Holy Spirit. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The fourth glorious mystery, the Assumption of Mary into Heaven. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The fifth glorious mystery, the crowning of Our Lady, Queen of Heaven. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve, To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal salvation, grant, we beseech thee, that by meditating upon these mysteries, the Most Holy Rosary, the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. May the divine assistance remain always with us, and may the souls of the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Jesus says, "Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest." Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you give us the Eucharist as the memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of this sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you won for us and the peace of your kingdom, where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
And so now, friends, can I invite you, wherever you're able to do so, to stand in honour and reverence of the Blessed Sacrament. As the Blessed Sacrament has been brought around the floor of the Basilica to each chapel, we pray for the gift of healing in our lives, be it personal, maybe for those who have asked for our prayers, those who have no one to pray for them, those who are very seriously ill at the moment, perhaps confined to homes, nursing homes, and hospitals. Those of you here present who are ill, anyone ill in mind, body, or spirit. Lord, touch with your healing hand all who labor and are overburdened among us today. Let your Spirit bring to all who are sick wholeness in body and healing of heart. Relieve the sufferings of all who live with continuous pain. Hear our prayers for everyone attending doctors and hospitals. Surround with love those handicapped in mind or body and all elderly people. With faith in your power to bring healing, we pray for children who are sick. Lord, we come to you in our brokenness, wounded in our relationships, wounded by our memory of painful experiences in times past, wounded by sin and guilt in our lives today. Lord Jesus, you are the bread of life. You came to feed the lonely with your company, to feed the sad with your hope. Your love touched all you met. You helped them change and grow. You nourished them with your love and led them to the Father. Your love opened them to the Spirit of love. As we meet you, the bread of life, feed us, we pray, with your love. Lead us to the Father. Open us to your Holy Spirit so that we can care for others and help them grow in your love. Stay with us, Jesus, as evening begins to fall, and be our companion on our way. Set our hearts on fire with new hope, so that we may recognize you in the Scriptures and in the breaking of bread. Jesus, we believe in you, we hope in you, we love you. Strengthen our faith, renew our hope and love, and grant our prayers. Touch with your healing love, O Lord, all who feel the hurt of life's wounds. Long ago, when people prayed to you for healing, you listened to them, blessed them, and answered their prayer. Heal us now of our sinfulness and of the hatred that divides us. Take away our hardness of heart. Open our eyes, which are often blind to the needs of others. Remove our selfishness and our greed. Give us self-control at all times, and fill our hearts with your eternal love. Jesus, we ask you now to heal us, to bless us, and to fill us with your peace. Let the sacrament of your body and blood bring healing to us all, for you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Now, friends, just before we conclude, I invite Father Pat to bless any religious objects you may happen to have with you, to thank you sincerely for being with us today in such wonderful numbers, to thank our choir, the Kajma Choir, with their director, George Lee, and our own organist, Una Nolan. Thank you very much indeed for enhancing our celebration. A word of thanks to Father Pat for conducting our celebration and celebrating our Mass this afternoon, and also to John F. Dean for, I think, a very thought-provoking and wonderful exposition on Mary in the context of faith. So thank you very much indeed, John, for that. It's wonderful. Those who wish to join John's seminar workshop at 6 o'clock, feel free to do so. It's in the Rest and Care, just over where I'm pointing here. Tomorrow is the 21st of August, the anniversary of the apparition itself, the 136th year of the apparition. It's the feast day we celebrate here of Our Lady of Knock. It is the 80th anniversary of Knock Shrine Society. That's the stewards and handmaids that you can see here coming out just front here, and who work here for the last 80 years at the shrine, enhancing the shrine and being part and parcel of the shrine itself. It's their birthday tomorrow, and we celebrate that. Also, yes, absolutely, they deserve a clap for that. We will be honouring them tomorrow. Tomorrow evening, the Archbishop will be here to celebrate a special Mass for them. And with that in mind, just might keep in mind a witness prayer where we'll gather tomorrow evening at 7:45, a quarter to eight, at the Apparition Chapel for those of you who wish to join us for a special little prayer, 15 minutes, where we'll pause at 8 o'clock for a moment's silence, the exact time of the apparition itself. And then we will conduct a procession to the Basilica. We conducted this last year. It was a wonderful occasion, and you're most welcome to join us for that unique little celebration. It also honours the witnesses of the apparition itself. Monica Morley conducts our workshop tomorrow, the director of the Family Centre here at Knock, and we'll discuss about how Knock plays a role in welcoming families to the shrine. So a lot on tomorrow. Please be part and parcel of it and join us for a special celebration. Just remains for me to wish you a safe journey home. Thanks to those who joined us on our webcam and on the internet. Thank you very much indeed. We hope that you will join us again. And Father Pat now will bless any religious objects you may happen to have with you.
Almighty Father, bless these medals and religious objects. May the saving presence of Christ be in the hearts of those who use them and in the homes in which they are placed. I bless them now in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us bow our heads now and pray for God's blessing as we leave Knock Shrine today. Father, in your great mercy, help your pilgrim people to remain close to you in prayer and give them a true love for each other. We have come to Knock to give you thanks and to petition you for our needs. We have prayed and celebrated the Eucharist together. As we journey from Knock, keep alive in us the memory of your love. May we bring from this place strength to carry our burdens and zeal to live the gospel. To the prayers of Our Lady of Knock, we are confident that you will watch over us always and fill our hearts with your love. Grant this to Christ our Lord. Amen. Our pilgrimage to Knock Shrine has come to an end. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Amen. Thanks be to God.